Good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms. You know, it's been a really warm or mild winter when you think of things. Or fall's just been one long extended fall.
Very true.
Or we're starting spring early, however you want to state it. But the ground really isn't frozen hard. And it's time to start thinking, maybe, do we plant early? Do we still worry about a late frost?
Well, you know that better than I would, but I would say on average we're still going to have some weather, right? I mean, I would assume that we could still. So I'd be careful, but there are some things you can plant early right outside now. Things like onion sets are good to go outside now. Peas, you can start thinking about some of your perennial vegetables like rhubarb, asparagus.
These are cold weather crops, so if we still have a freeze or two in there or some frost, those plants really aren't affected.
No, it'll knock them back a little bit, but it won't slow
them
down.
Just like the weeds in my yard. Right?
There you go. Yeah. Greenest they've ever been.
Right. But we can start some stuff indoors that's a little more frost or freeze sensitive, but they take a few weeks to get going anyway.
They do, and what we usually suggest is take a look at a planting guide. They're available online through the Grow to Eat It campaign for the University of Maryland, or we have one here at Valley View. And it gives you basic dates that things should go outside, and you kind of count backwards from there, 6 to 8 weeks, to know when you should start your seeds indoors.
Right, depending on what part of town you live. Because a different situation near the Pennsylvania line is down near Annapolis.
Exactly.
As far as how early things get going. But needless to say, in any normal year, and this has not been a normal year, we could get a freeze or a frost into May.
Absolutely.
And a freeze into April. So,
yep, our last average frost date out here is going to be right around Mother's Day. As you're in the city, it's probably towards the end of April. If you're near the water anywhere along the bay, it's going to be much earlier than if you're out towards the mountains.
Absolutely. Now, we've got some neat little devices here to get something started. Well, you could just have a flat full of soil and put seeds in it. Or you could be organized and soak these little jobbies. This looks like a checker piece, and it becomes one of these. The plant grows. This is biodegradable. You just set it in the pot when you're ready to go, and
it's nice. And you put it.
Or you can put them right in the ground, I suppose, too.
Exactly. Sure. Yeah. And you can use a plastic flat like this and just keep reusing that and just get new pellets. So that's nice. A very sustainable way to go. Now a lot of seeds are a lot of different. These are tomato seeds, and these are from a company that pelletizes some of their seeds, and what this does, it puts an extra seed coating on, so if the plants should dry out a little bit, it's going to kind of help it through, and it honestly makes it so much easier to plant.
Yes, especially if you're doing just a flat full of soil, you can see where you put the seeds, because they're, in that case, they're white.
And I'm just going to set them each here in the middle, and then I'm going to go back and just poke them down, and then you've got...
I've got pepper seeds. Now, these aren't coated or anything like that. They're just these little flat little seeds, and I'm going to do the same thing. Put them in this little depression down here. Now, you mentioned something about sometimes it's maybe good to put a couple in each.
Yeah, a lot of times one definitely comes out stronger than the other, and then all you have to do is go back and cut the weaker of the two out.
Just cut it.
You don't really want to pull it out because you don't want to mess with the root systems too much.
Oh, yeah, you cut it at that early stage, it just won't be viable. Yeah.
So we've moistened these ahead of time, so they're all ready to go that way, and we'll add a little bit more water probably tomorrow, just as we see how this dries out. But to keep it from drying out too much, we're going to put a little plastic dome on here. And you can use saran wrap if you don't have a dome, you know, something along those lines.
And this is good until we start seeing leaves come up.
Right, exactly.
We can leave this little dome on here until the leaves emerge.
So in most cases, you're only talking about a week or so that you have the dome on. Take that off. Make sure you take it off every once in a while so it doesn't stay too wet, but it's good to keep it moist.
But once the leaves come out, if you leave this on, they could get moldy.
Right.
And then you've bad crop.
And at this point, the seeds need heat. So if you don't have a house that's 70, 80 degrees, you might want to get one of these heat
mats. So that they germinate.
So they get going up there. Yep. We have one greenhouse at our farm that's specifically for germinating. It's a little bit hotter than all the rest just to get the heat levels up.
And you put a heating pad.
Exactly.
You know, very
that's
nice
all
thing.
It is.
Once the leaves come out, if your light's not optimum wherever you're putting it, you've got special fluorescent bulbs. So they're lower energy consuming bulbs, but they have a specific spectrum that mimics sunlight.
Exactly. And you keep these on for 12 to 14 hours a day and keep them relatively close to the plant. So as the plant grows, you move the light up. And there are also incandescent fixtures like that. They're not quite as efficient because they put out a lot of heat, too. But if that's the way you go, you know, that's fine.
But the important thing is the sun-like spectrum.
Exactly,
not
to get that nice
standard
wide
light.
Daylight type stuff.
Well, you know what? We're out of time.
Okay.
But we've gotten some tips here of getting the garden going early. And maybe this is the early year because of the winter we've had. It's crazy. Carrie, thanks for joining us
this
morning. Next Sunday, more on your Sunday Gardener. We'll see you then.
And if you have a question for Sunday Gardener, just send it in to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211.